When you do the colors right in ripstop nylon, it looks just like stained glass.
I'm joined by master kite builder Jon Burkhardt. We're here in your studio. Thank you so much for showing us around.
A real pleasure.
Now, I see some designs of kites here. Can you tell us about what I'm seeing here on the table?
I decided to try to do something really different. And this is not a design I've seen anybody else do. But I was working, first of all, with cardboard to get angles right and proportions right and all of that. And so I followed that up with this drawing. And then you notice I've got it on graph paper. So it's really easy to measure. And then I started thinking about, well, what do I really want to build? And what I want to build is a big kite. I want to build a kite that's almost 9 feet tall. Yeah, so I'm going through all the proportions and figuring that out, and I've got the size figured out. Now, you know, if I'm gonna cut up 9 feet of fabric, I wanna see if it flies. So what I did was I made this particular model. Some people call them maquettes, and took it out and flew it around. And that's to test the kind of structure that I have in mind. And what I found is that, yeah, this is a good start, but I want to make some improvements. This kite kind of tends to pocket between these crossbars. And what I want it to do is I want it to lay real smooth. My test flight generally said that I could do bridling like this from the spine.
So your original design was okay, but you're actually making improvements on that, almost like a writer revising their work.
Yes.
That's really interesting. Right. Now, this isn't the only scale model that you've got. You've got another one back over here, right?
That's right, we do. This is a kite. The graphics are designed by my wife, Karen. And this is called We Become Birds. She made the design, and I made this to test out the colors and to test out the shape and the aerodynamics. And now we've made a much bigger one, and it's won a lot of prizes, but it's too big to put up here in the studio.
I was gonna say, can we see it?
We can see it.
We can see that we've moved outside now, and we've got the model here in the full scale. And Jon, the colors on this are just amazing. Can you tell me about the colors?
Sure. When you do the colors right in ripstop nylon, it looks just like stained glass. And that's what we're trying to do. There are areas here where there are multiple layers of fabric. And of course, we've got the stitching that gives you a particular effect that we also want to emphasize.
So when you're putting the colors together, you're really thinking about what it's going to look like in the air, aren't you?
Absolutely. It has to look good when it's hundreds of feet away.
Well, you've accomplished that. This is amazing. Thank you so much for sharing with us today.
Thank you, Marty.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.